I did it. I won the third match in the final four. I won my match today for the club championship to get into the finals. Here is the score here. I ended up shooting, I actually had four birdies on the back. And man, what an absolute crazy match. I kind of feel like crying actually. So if I cry, I apologize in advance. But oh my gosh, what a great day. It started off, it's interesting talking about mindset. You know, I am a mental performance golf coach, and something my wife said last night really, really stuck with me. And she said, you need to feel it. You need to know it. You need to embody it. You need to know that you have it. Like it's already done. And so, cause I was having trouble, last night, like in the evening, just trying to relax. And so before bed, we kind of talked about it, and she's just like, yeah, it's already done. You've already won. You just have to go do the thing. And it really was the only thing that helped me relax. And very helpful. And I kind of remembered that all morning long. Like it's, you know, this is already done. You know, I've already won this, you know, I'm just acting as if, and, oh my gosh, good stuff. So, but yeah, I kind of started off a little shaky. I hit absolutely gorgeous drive on the first hole, and then chunked a wedge because I was just so nervous. And it was kind of an in-between club and whatever, insert excuse here. But yeah, I ended up bogeying the first hole. So I'm one down after the first hole, and I haven't been down this, you know, the last 2 weeks. I have not been down in any match at all. So I'm one down, and I'm like, all right, well, is what it is. Step up, he hits a good shot on the green on the par three. I miss it to the right, I miss it short, but I hit a good chip shot, okay chip shot, had about 6 or 7 feet, maybe 8 feet, make it for par, huge par, but then go into the next hole and hit a shot way right, almost in the water actually, so far right, it's kind of silly, and then didn't hit a good iron in, I hit a tree, chipped up, this, that, and the other. Anyways, the guy's up on the green, he makes a par, and on to the next. So I'm two down after three holes, and I'm like, all right, I just need some momentum. And in my mind, I had watched a video with the Sandbagger guy on YouTube, and shout out to Sandbagger. But I watched his video, he was playing in a match play, and he went on this run and birdied like six holes in a row. And I was like, that's amazing. And I'm like, you know, I could do that out here. I could do that. I could birdie six in a row. I mean, I birdied four in a row and shot 33 like the last week. So I'm like, I could do that. So kind of in my mind was just like, I'm going to go on a run. I'm a good putter. I'm going to make some putts. It's just a matter of time. I just got to hang around there. I don't care if I'm, you know, four down. It doesn't matter. I'm going to make six birdies in a row and just take this thing around. And I ended up... on the short par four, I had kind of a crappy lie and I didn't hit that great of a shot. And so I left myself a little short, a little upset about that. Not upset, but you know, it is what it is. And I'm just like, I'm just going to make this. So I chip in for birdie to win the hole, back to being only one down. I made a great par on the next hole and the guy had a little trouble. So now we're even. And now we're even after five holes, even after six holes. And then, I lose the seventh hole. It just didn't work out. I made kind of a dumb bogey. I didn't get up and it just didn't work out. I'm like, that's fine. So then I step up number eight, birdie. I almost, you know, drive it pretty close to the green on the short par four. Perfect drive, chip up, make birdie, back to even. And then I turn around and I make a decent par on the next hole, but I put myself in a bad spot. I was in the bunker, short-sighted, nothing I could do. Just misread the putt, just missed it. So then we're back to one down on the back nine. And then I just kind of go on a tear. You know, we par the first hole, which was fine. Made a decent putt on that hole to par it. And then I make this really long birdie putt on number 11 and on the par three. And it was like awesome. So now we're back to even. Good putt on number 12. Back, you know, doing good. Then I go birdie to go up one up, to go two up on 13, 14. I lose 15. I hit just a bad tee shot, chunked it, and I just missed the putt. It was actually not a bad putt, but I just played it poorly. So back to one up. I make an amazing par on 16 after I hit my tee shot right. I've got this four iron that I've got to hit low. I hit it just, it was bad luck. I hit it way right. And I've got this ridiculously 30-yard chip shot up past this tree. Hit it up on the green. Got about 8 feet. Make that for par. Huge par. One up. Going into 17. Hit not a very good shot, drive, He hits a good drive. I chip up. Not that great. Short. It just was another bad 4-iron chip shot. Just not good. End up making bogey. He makes par. So we're even going into the last hole, boys and girls. Last hole, par 5. I'm very nervous. He goes first. He hits a good drive. I go next, and I just blast one. I actually hit it so far that it went through the fairway into the rough a little bit, but that's okay. I got about 205 in. I'm like, let's do this. And I'm just like, I kept telling myself, I'm like, one good shot. Just hit one good shot. You hit a great drive. Let's hit one more good shot. And I had 4-iron because I wanted to make sure, if anything, I would be a little short. I didn't want to be passed. Hit a decent 4-iron, bounced up in the fairway bunker. He chips up, decent chip shot. I've got a bunker shot. I hit a great bunker shot. I got about 8 feet, 6 or 8 feet left, probably 6 or 7 feet. I don't know. It was all blur. And I read the putt. He missed his. So here it is. I'm sitting on the last hole. Just what you want, right? Last hole with a putt to win. I read it. I looked at my yardage book. I looked at everything. I read it from every side. I stepped up to go putt it, and I was about to putt it, and my hands are literally shaking, and I was like, okay, maybe I should back off. And anytime anything comes in my mind, I'm like, okay, it's time to back off. So I backed off. I stepped back up, and my hands were shaking again, and I was just like, I'm just going to have to make this putt with my hands shaking. So I step up, take my practice swing, look at it, and drain the putt to make it for birdie, and end up shooting 34 in the back and winning the match, and super excited. The other match, there's an older guy that's got about 12 or 13 club championships, and he was playing a younger guy, actually another high school golf coach, a boys team, and he was down like probably 2 or 3 late in the game, but he just made a couple birdies, played good. They went to extra holes. He made a good par on the next hole, and then the other guy kind of messed up. So it's going to be an all John. His name's John as well, and I think he's like 72, so super nice guy. So on to the finals. It's John and John for the finals. It is Coach Lemon against the 12-time club champion. And he's also got 13 runner-ups, so 36 holes for all the marbles next Sunday. So thanks for following along, guys. Cheers. Have a great day.